What's up, everyone, and welcome back to Austin Boats and Motors. This is Kurt Zimmerman, and today I'm going to be walking you guys through this all-new 2021 Ranger 2510. We just got this bad boy in from the factory, and I'm just going to do a quick walkthrough with you guys and show you a little of the storage compartments and what this boat has to offer. All right, starting here at the Ranger Trail trailer that comes paired with the boat, you're going to have a boarding step here in the front, a center jack for better support, and a spare tire with a spare tire holder right there, as you can see. And you've got that beautiful black and white color with the matching T-top. It's a good looking boat right here, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be powered by a Mercury 350 Verado, so that's going to be plenty of horsepower to move this thing down the lake here. And it's going to come with a three-blade stainless steel prop. You've got a boarding ladder here in the back. Call that a telescoping ladder, stainless steel. And then right below that, you can see these plates. Those are going to be your Lenco actuators. It's going to get you up on plane better, and you can adjust the running attitude of the boat with those. All right, hopping into the back here. You can see you have a big casting deck here in the aft. And then if you lift this area up, actually turns into bucket seating with an area for two beverages as well. You've got your Ranger logo on there, that nice interior. And then if you want, you can always fold that down and just have your casting deck. Sorry guys, my shock popped out right here. Get that back in there. So here in the back, you're going to have a small Baitwell area with a light and an aerator. Over here on your starboard side, it's just going to be like a dry box area. You do have a drain in there, so a lot of people like to use this area for a cooler. These are all lockable stainless steel compartments as well. You've got your wash down here in the back, so you can fill your water up right there for your wash down. And this is going to be your raw water wash down. So you'll hook a hose up there and you can spray out the boat here, and it'll all the water will enter through these drains in the back if you get that jack high enough in the front. As you can see, you're going to have rod storage throughout the boat everywhere, all along the gunwale for trolling, all along the back of the leaning post, and of course up on the T-top as well. Plenty of areas to grab onto the boat on those rough days. Even back here where you've got your see-through live well, has an aerator and a light as well, and it is massively deep. As you guys can tell, it goes all the way to the bottom of the console here. All right, moving right along, more rod storage along the console. Let's take a look at that leaning post. Something I like that they did, they separated these, so if your driver wanted to be sitting comfortable, passenger wanted to be leaning, you can do that. You've got a nice area for your feet, so you can, when you got this leaning post up, you can see way over the windshield here. And you are going to have a Hummingbird Solix 12, basically like a TV screen on here. Got all your basic toggle switches right above that. And it does come with an Infinity Bluetooth stereo system. You're gonna have four speakers along the T-top, two in the front, two in the back. Some additional storage up here on the T-top as well. Let me go through a couple of the specs with you guys. So this boat is going to be 24 foot long with a beam of 102 inches. The inside depth of your gunwale walls here are going to be 19 inches, so if you got any kids on the boat, they should be plenty safe in here. You've got really tall gunwale walls, so they won't go flying out when you hit those big wakes. and the draft on this boat is going to be 14 inches. It's got a fuel capacity of 97 gallons. All right, let me get up here and show you guys some of the bow, and then we'll call it a day. As you can see here in the front, we've got your cushion snapped in. So basically when you're taking the family out, you just want to have a cruise day. And the comfortability of this boat, you'll have your cushions laid out. If you do want to store those though, that's how you're going to get to all your compartments down here, your rod lockers on port and starboard side. I like to store your cushions in the console here, and they'll all fit in there, no problem. And then you've got a mirror right here also for the ladies. So let me move. I've got this one center cushion pulled out as of now. This is going to be where you're going to put your big catch of the day on ice. So plenty of room in here for those big fish. And then let's take a look at some of your rod storage. And as I said before, all these are lockable compartments, stainless steel locks. See what your port side's looking like. You got the nice Ranger matting on the bottom. Looks like it holds 6 rods in here. You've got your fan system to keep it dry in here from moisture and mildew. And you're gonna have the same over here on your starboard side underneath the cushion as well. Up here in the front, they give you a spot for an anchor. And something I love that they did is added this cleat so you can tie right off to that. You don't have to go off your eyelid up front or any of your other cleats. Oh yeah, you've also got some nice handrails for when you're sitting high. You see those cushions kind of sit you high up there so you can hold on for better support. And then that beautiful T-top with your Ranger logo. All right, guys, I think that's pretty much going to do it today on this 2510 Ranger. If you guys have any more questions, feel free and stop and see us here at Austin Boats and Motors in Lakeway, Texas, or give us a call at 512-263-2811. Thanks and have a great day.